Hi, everyone, and welcome to, I just forgot what week is it. This is week 9 already of the creative stretch. We are like beyond the home stretch and sliding into the finish line. I know Cindy loves sports and probably has way better sports analogies than I do, but we're here today with Cindy Winsel with 3 really fascinating words that I don't know that I personally thought about them through the lens of values and feel like I still need a little more connection and exploration. I haven't done any writing yet around these. So I'm super curious to be in conversation with Cindy and Andrea today about resourcefulness, simplicity, and solving problems. So Andrea, let's talk about resourcefulness.
So you said what you just said, and I'm wondering if maybe you just misspoke, but you just said you haven't thought about them as values yet.
Yeah. When I read through the list, and I was looking at definitions this morning.
Yeah.
And, you know, sometimes there's words that really resonate with me or feel really interesting. Or even some of the ways you talked about like integrity and your connection to God, like they're just integral parts of who you are.
Right.
So sometimes I'm looking at resourcefulness going, how do I think about this through the lens of seeing it as a core value for myself?
Okay. I get it. So these ones are again, and I don't know, the deeper we get into it, the harder it is for me to pick ones that rise above because, man, resourcefulness and solving problems to me, those two go like, it's hard for me to split them apart because you have to be resourceful to solve problems. Like, I don't know how you can solve problems without being resourceful.
Yeah.
Like, how does that happen? So I can't separate those two really. Problems arise. We must solve them. Yes. That is right. I've often called myself the build a better mousetrap kind of person. I will fabricate a problem to solve it because that is my sweet spot. I love figuring out a better way to do something. I'm married to an engineer. It's in my home. It's in my DNA. It's in my everyday living. I kid you not. It is my every waking breathing moment is solving problems. Do I go after problem? I just said I did. Because I like that sort of like, okay, how are we going to make this happen? It's that resourcefulness. It's drawing on that my talents and gifts. Number one, my creativity, is a huge factor of my resource. That's one of my biggest resources, right? Yeah. The way that I can use my creative mind is how I solve problems. And then to spin it right back around to simplicity, most of the time, the solution is keep it as simple as possible. Don't overcomplicate things, Andrea. Yes. How simple can I make it? Right?
Yeah.
So there we go. Wham, bam. Thank you, ma'am. They're all three wrapped up into one. It's crazy how I don't know how this happens that they're just alphabetically so well suited for one another.
I know.
I'm curious if we would reach into a bag and draw three out, if we would be having the same conversation.
Well, that's a fun idea because we're already thinking about the next iteration of this next spring. And, you know, I think we're pretty clear that these words have been so magical. We're not going to change the words. Initially, we thought,
Don't say never, because I want to talk to you about that, but go ahead. Keep going. Say never.
All right. So this is our thing is we have creative ideas away from each other and creative ideas together, and they all end up happening perfectly. But so many of these words, I don't think I could take off the list.
I know.
And feel in integrity. Anyway, but that's a fun idea to mix them up and put them in a different order. So Cindy,
maybe they've just been sitting together on the page for a long enough time that they've simmered together. Because I looked at them, I was like, no, they don't really, you know, go together. But now I feel like without simplicity, I'm going to have a hard time or longer time solving a problem. Mm-hmm. So it's going to take me longer. And so if I can be, you know, resourceful and use the things that I have and be simple about it, then I'll be able to solve the problem. And I'm like you guys, like if there's a problem, I'll figure it out. Mm-hmm. I will figure it out and I will solve that. So that simplicity came to me because I think sometimes I have a challenge with that. I challenge because there's so much stuff that I could use. And so now I'm starting to limit the options, limit the choices, sometimes, not always, but sometimes, to get to where I want to go.
Mm, I love that.
Yeah, it is amazing how they all
like, and that's mm-hmm. not just like art supplies, like limiting what art supplies you're using for a project, but also in your business success as well, and what you're offering, and in your life. And I imagine as a teacher for so long, that simplicity was something that supported you as well as problem solving and resourcefulness in the classroom, like learning right. how to connect to your students in a way that didn't inundate yeah. them with information as well.
Yeah, absolutely. That and it does transfer to other areas of my life. Like with students, it was, this student is not getting it, or this group of students is struggling. What can I do differently to help them see what it is I want them to see? Mm-hmm. And sometimes it was other students explaining it, that they needed that kind of language. So it's amazing how it does transfer to other parts of our lives, for sure. And I think, in education, I knew it, but in the creative world, there's so much that is different for me that I'm having to learn how to be more simple, or not simple, but use simplicity more.
Yeah. Yeah. And sometimes it is just being simple, not simple thinking in the negative yeah. terminology, but simple in our approach, right? Like I was right. watching Andrea in her Under the Influence class last night, and I love how she problem solves on a page and how she tries new things and experiments. So there's a lot of resourcefulness and, oh, what's right here within my grasp that I can just grab on her magic table.
I'm wondering if it's resourcefulness and problem solving, or is that laziness that I don't want to get up and get up to walk across the room?
Yeah.
Okay. It's resourcefulness. Let's take resourcefulness. Sure.
Yeah.
Sure.
Yeah.
Yeah. But I think for me personally, I can so tend to overcomplicate things that, and usually in the realm of ideas or the scope of a project. And so that learning to keep it simple has been a big learning curve for me. Or when, like, planning a trip for Christmas with four adults, one who's working in Colorado, one who has to come home from college and then travel with us, and we're traveling to Vancouver, we got to make sure all the everybody's passports are up to date to go across the border. So we've got like all these different sets of airplane tickets going multiple directions, hotel reservations to make. My husband has to take time off from work. We got to find a cat sitter so the kitties don't have to go to the boarding house that they don't love, right? It's mm-hmm. just that every tiny little aspect of our life can end up getting smooshed together, even trying to plan our summers around, family schedules and who's where what. And at Christmas, my sister-in-law is like, well, we've already booked a ski trip and we're going to be gone these dates. And it's like, holy moly, this is a lot of complexity, right? And so for me, if I can get it back down to the bare bones, right? And I talked through this even with Andrea, the resourceful part of me that doesn't like to waste time or money, which is a big part of me, started looking at the cost for all of these things for the short period of time that we're going to be in Vancouver with Brad's family. And I'm like, we could take the family for a week to Hawaii for what it's going to cost us to go to cold, Vancouver for Christmas. And then I remember we're going because we haven't seen Brad's parents. And she's like, think of it like a vacation. And that just simple mm-hmm. mindset shift changed my whole perspective. So I upgraded Brad and I's hotel room, right? And we're staying at the beach in a little room with a fireplace. The kids are staying somewhere else with their aunt and uncle. So all of a sudden that mindset around problem solving and seeing where I get in my own way, I think is something where simplicity feels like an anchor that brings me back, right, to clarity and remembering I'm good at solving problems. I am very resourceful. You know, think back to when we were all single and, you know, scrappy and trying to do things on tight budgets, you know, all the things that we learned in those early years in my comfortable, you know, 50s, right? And like, it looks very different. And sometimes I forget how resourceful I used to be. And I have to remember to reflect back that way as well. So Cindy, I'm curious. I loved your perspective on simplicity. But where do you see resourcefulness and solving problems coming into play when you're at the page, looking at the page?
Yeah. You know, so much of it is intuitive for me that I mostly draw on that, but then I look at other people's work as well. And, you know, over time, I'm more drawn to one thing over another. And when it comes to the creative part, that seems to flow just fine. It's when, like you talked about the learning curve, I've had so many learning curves within this process with technology mostly that that's where I can make it so complicated. And I'm like, stop, you know, I don't have to, like Andrea said, you know, first, not only. So that's so powerful, that phrase, because I have to remember, oh yeah, first of all, I'm learning this new thing. And once I get it, then I can go back and do it again in a more simple manner. So I don't know if that answered your question at all, but it feels like that to me, that it's when I know what I'm doing, I can right out of the base, you know, it's simplicity. But if I don't know what I'm doing, then I tend to make things complicated until I get it.
It makes me think about how important to all three of these values, the idea of beginner's mind is, which is similar to first, not only, but that learning curve. Like, we have a lot of people in the creative stretch community who are new to mixed media art. And so there is that learning curve of the process and learning the supplies and even getting on Zoom calls, although I think we're all pretty handy at that these days. But I appreciate that perspective of once you're in the moment, you know, you really trust and honor your intuition, which also are a big part of problem solving and resourcefulness, really learning that self-trust to and letting go of our need to make something beautiful at the, you know, every single time that we start.
Right. Yeah. Yeah. It's very much that way. You know, and along with the simplicity, I tend to need structure with that. And I do better if I have, you know, a deadline, even if it's a soft deadline, it helps me, you know, get to the problem solving and the resourcefulness as well. So I know that about myself, that I need that within those three values.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Structure would be a great one to include and talk about as well. Other thoughts from you, Andrea, on these three values or anything Cindy and I said spark new ideas for you?
Yeah, I think for me, simplicity is the, you know, I wouldn't say outlier, but that's not the one that I gravitate towards because I'm a more is more kind of girl. I mean, clearly, like I long for simplicity sometimes. I look around my surroundings and I had a huge mess to clean up after my class last night. And I was just lamenting the fact that I haven't made life simple because I just, you know, collect lots of things. And, you know, simplicity would make things a lot easier to clean up messes and, you know, things like that. So I think simplicity is one that I would like to work on more. It's a highly aspirational value, highly aspirational. It's definitely not one that rises to the top of like, oh yeah, that's one that I hold really, you know, like I do that one well.
Yeah.
But it's definitely a highly aspirational. I could see how it would
benefit me and my life and open things up. We were talking last night and it's come up several times of November being a month for
Cheryl Moot shared that in our group.
Yeah, Cheryl Moot shared that in our group. And the day before I had heard somebody in my studio saying, the exact same thing. Two people from two totally different places mentioned this, the November. Mm-hmm. And so I've been thinking like, what can I say no to? And that's kind of a, you know, simplify your life by taking on less. Mm-hmm. So yeah, I like the simplicity core value. It's not one that I'm super strong at, but it is. And I think that that happens every time we have these, the core values. There's some that we are like, oh yeah, that one. That one is, you know, I've got good strength in that, or I really want to say that that's where I'm really shining. And then there's other ones where I'm like, yeah, I could definitely polish that one off a little bit and tend to try and use that a little bit more.
Yeah,
I know that's why I chose it. I chose that. I know I chose simplicity because, well, look at my background.
But I love that you can close it, even if you never choose to close it.
I can close it, yes. And I would if I had to. Yeah. But I know that's why I chose that word, because it is a point of challenge for me. And Andrea, I remember you saying, well, you devised this little checklist, mm-hmm. you know, that you wanted to put away, you know, things. When you were done. And I think that's a great idea. Sometimes I'm just spent, you know, and I just leave it and then come back the next day. But I like that. I like that idea of making things more simple by putting away, you know, the things I used for a certain project right away. I definitely have some work to get there.
I love that, because I think that connects us full circle to solving problems and resourcefulness, right? Like, you know, then we can be resourceful in the way that we store things, or, you know, resourceful in the way that we have access to the things that we use the most. So I cannot work on a super cluttered table. And so I usually, like, if it's an evening class, I will clean up the next morning, but I will clean up, or at least go
Doom. You've heard of Doom boxes, right?
Yeah.
Fill another Doom box.
Put it in a tray and put it to the side.
Yes.
And those boxes behind me, they're like plastic boxes that go in those slots.
Yes.
Well, I finally did this. I labeled them with what's in there. Yeah. That has made life so much more simpler.
Yeah.
Just
I have
to know what's in there.
A son who loved that kind of organizational stuff. So Maggie organized all my art supplies, labeled all the bins. And then I get in trouble for not sustaining the beautiful system that she's created, but it's so much better than it was before. But it's funny that this is the way that the conversation has gone. But I think, you know, if we start talking about solving problems, simplicity and resourcefulness, paper management. Like when I watch all the little scraps that Andrea or some of the other mixed media artists keep, I'm like, hell no, pardon my language. I'm like, there's no way I want to keep track of even more scraps of paper. And I do a decent job. But after like a day of gel printing, I taught my mom to gel print on Monday afternoon. We had so much fun. But now, you know, there's this whole new stack of paper that needs to get back to California. If you're wondering where I am, I'm in Colorado this week hanging out with my mom. And I'm like, okay, I got to get them back. And then when I get them back, they need a home. And so paper management is probably the bane of my existence when it comes to crafting.
Yeah. Yeah, there was this gal in our retreat this past week that we made a bunch of citral pages using National Geographic.
Yeah.
And it was like super, super fun. And we had it all spread out in the backyard and stuff. And so we're getting ready to pack up our little area. And she's like, I have all these papers and I don't want to take them home. And I'm like, so she gave them all to me. And I have them. I'm like, what? Yeah.
And they stay smelly. Yeah. Like I still have some I did with my mom and they stay smelly.
They sure do. Yes.
Yeah. 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 Which is a whole nother. All right. Well, clearly we could jam on resourcefulness, simplicity, and solving problems for days and bemoan the sad states of clutter in each of our studios. And instead, we're all going to aspire to be a little more intentional in looking for a little more simplicity in our lives and our spaces as we go forward. Cindy, thank you so much for being here.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for inviting me, and thank you for having me here. I've totally enjoyed all of this.
Yeah, and thank you for just playing full out and doing the work yourself, for showing up in the Facebook group and being so participatory. It's been lovely seeing you really commenting and sharing with other people as well. So I love it. Andrea, any final words from you?
Nope, I think we got it. This is a great week, and I can't wait to see the lessons that you guys do.
Yeah.
I can't wait to see the lesson that I do, because I have no idea what I
do. Yeah, so if you guys are curious, we record these in advance. And so we're still playing, you know, catch up on next week, much less like 3 or 4 weeks from now. But to me, the beauty and the magic of this is like having this conversation with the two of you. I'm like,
Now it helps me. I'm ready to record now on what am I going to do?
Solving problems.
Yeah.
There you go.
So there we go.
Brilliant. All right. Thank you both. See you
soon.
Thank you.
Bye.